Hello, my dear students. As teammates, you are responsible to make sure you and the people around you follow the instructions given by the government to fight against COVID-19. Is it right? Yes. Now I am here to teach you nouns. In the previous class, we have learned what is a noun. What is a noun? A noun is the name of a person, place, animal, or thing. What do you mean by a noun? A noun is the name of a person, place, animal, or thing. Then, today I am going to teach you what is singular nouns and what is plural nouns. A noun that names only one person, place, animal, or thing is called plural, singular nouns. A noun that names only one person, place, animal or thing is called singular nouns. Listen once more. A noun that names only one person, place, animal or thing is called singular nouns. Then what do you mean by plural noun? A noun that names more than one person, place, animal or thing is called plural nouns. Okay, understand. Then what do you mean by a singular noun and what do you mean by a plural noun? A noun that names only one person, place or thing is called singular nouns. For example, pen is a singular noun. Then what is the plural form of this pen? Pens. What is the plural form of this pen? Pens. Then a noun that names only one person, place or thing is called singular nouns. A noun that names more than one person, place, animal or thing is called plural noun. Then for example, doll. What is the plural form of this word? Dolls. Next one, pencil. What is the plural form of pencil? Pencils. Pencils. That means a noun that names only one person, place or animal or thing is called singular nouns. A noun that names more than one person, place or thing is called plural nouns. For example, what is this? Pencil. A singular noun. Only one pencil. Then what is this? Pencils. Pencil. Pencils. Singular, plural. A noun that names only one person, place, animal or thing is called singular noun. This is singular pencil. A noun that names more than one person, place, animal or thing is called plural nouns. This is pencil. Next one, pen, pens. This is singular and this is plural. This is singular. This one is plural. Pencils. Pen. Only one. Singular. Plural. Okay, all of you understand. Then what you learn today? A noun that names only one person, place, animal or thing is called singular nouns. A noun that names more than one person, place, animal or thing is called plural nouns. Okay, all of you understand? Then, now, let's see. Listen, we add ES to the singular nouns that end with the letters S, SS, CH, SH or X to make the plural. If the singular noun ends with SS, S, SS, CH, SH or SX, what we should do? We will add ES to make the plural. Plural. For singular noun, avasanikkunnathu so, sso, cho, sho, xo. Anandil, what we will do? Then we must add es to make the plural. For example, bus. The word ends with s. Then what we will do? Then we must add es. So, bus, buses. Glass, glasses. Bench, benches. Brush, brushes. Box, boxes. Listen, We add es to the singular nouns that end with the letters s, ss, ch, sh, x to make them plural. For example, bus, buses, glass, glasses, bench, benches, brush, brushes, box, boxes. Listen once more. We add es to the singular nouns that end with the letters s, ss, ch, sh, or x to make them plural. Bus, buses, glass, glasses, bench, benches, brush, brushes, box, boxes. All of you understand? Then what we have learned today? We know that a noun is the name of a person, place, animal or thing. Then what do you mean by a singular noun? A noun that names only one person, place, animal or thing is called singular nouns. Then what do you mean by a plural noun? A noun that names more than one person, place, animal or thing is called plural nouns. Okay, all of you understand? Then are you ready to do an activity now? Okay. Listen, all of you. Here, singular and plural. Then what you should do? You should write the plural form of rose and dog. Again, you should write the singular form of cows and bats. Are you ready to do the activity now? Then you do one thing. All of you pause the video now and write the answer. When you finish, play the video again and check whether your answer is right. Are you ready? All of you pause the video now and write the answer. When you finish, play the video again and check your answer is right. Now I am going to write your answer here. Write the answer here. Rose, roses. Doll, dolls. Cow, cows. Bags, bag. All of you understand? All of you listen, all of you repeat after me. Rose, roses. Doll, dolls. Cow, cows. Bag, bags. Once more. Rose, roses. Doll, dolls. Cow, cows. Bag, bags. Okay, all of you, are you ready to do exercise from your grammar test? Okay. Then listen what we have learned today. A noun is the name of a person, place, animal or thing. A noun that names only one person, place, animal or thing is called singular noun. A noun that names more than one person, place, animal or thing is called plural noun. Okay, all of you understand? All of you take your grammar test. Page number 13. Harinarayanan, take your grammar test. Page number 13. Exercise E. Fill in the blanks. Singular, plural. Rose. What is the plural form of rose? Roses. Pencil, pencils. Doll, dolls. Then what is the singular form of trees? Tree. Pen, pens. Park, parks. Cow, cows. Computer, computers. Crow, crows. Bag, bags. Next one, exercise F. Write the plural form of the singular nouns. Bus, buses. Fox, foxes. Glass, glasses. Church, churches. Toothbrush, toothbrushes. Watch, watches. All of you take page number 12.
Karthik, take page number 12. Write the nouns given in the box in the correct columns. Some words are given here. Then you should check which are the words are singular and which are plural. Then this one is a homework. All of you should write the homework today itself. If you have any doubt, you can contact me. Are you ready to do it? Yes. Okay.
I think all of you understand how to write singular nouns and plural nouns. Complete your grammar test today itself. If you have any doubt, you can contact me. Thank you all.